Now on BBC 4, another award-winning Paul Bowden documentary on the infamous Beast of Carrot Chase.
I'm a glacier boulder on Carrot Chase in Staffordshire to investigate a mystery of a sharp claws and a rather curly tail.
I am of course referring to the Beast of Carrot Chase, the infamous local legend of a black leopard prowling the woodlands and preying on deer. In this documentary, I seek to discover the truth behind this local icon that is flooding regional headlines and causing quite an upstart.
Like most stories of this nature, the Beast of Carrot Chase is often fobbed off, with local journalists even describing it as tabloid drivel conjured up to sell papers. The local area has become infamous as a hotspot for supernatural sightings, with locals claiming to have seen yetis, werewolves and even UFOs roaming the chase. It's oddities like this that give rumours of big cats prowling the chase little chance of recognition and legitimacy.
One man who certainly does believe in the beast is researcher and author Neil Arnold of the Big Cat Research Facility in Kent. In a written statement, he told me that black leopards, also known as black panthers, would not shy away from carrot chase as it is a heavily wooded and mainly undisturbed area. He also claimed that black leopards pose little threat to humans, unless provoked, as they feed mostly upon deer, rabbit, fox and pigeons late at night when no one can disturb them.
So it seems there is scientific evidence to prove the beast's existence. Perhaps amongst tales of yetis and werewolves, there's room on the chase for a creature little less superstitious than Bigfoot.
In order to gain further insight into evidence behind the mystery, I contacted local forensics lecturer Bruce Fletcher, who has researched the subject extensively, in order to ask him whether or not he believed black leopards prowled the local woodland.
Currently, no, frankly. While newspapers are very quick to publish these stories, from a scientific perspective, the sightings have not been corroborated with any forensic evidence. So, to give you some examples of the sort of evidence which would prove unequivocally that cats did exist, could be matched blood samples, matched hair samples, could be footprints which are recovered, photographed and analysed to the extent where they give an accurate representation. There are video footage, still photographs, sound recordings of the animal's calls. One of the strongest pieces of evidence will be the analysis of the mutilated carcasses of the animals which these big cats are supposedly preying on, because big cats have a method of attack using claws to haul an animal down, and then very, very long incisors, longer than any other form of predator, to bite into the animal to suffocate its windpipe. These are what cats do, and they are accused of taking livestock, and yet none of this has been put forward as evidence. Now, that's not to say that they don't exist or haven't been recorded as existed. Shropshire, jungle cat run over, body found a few years ago. Mm-hmm. Norfolk, lynx, a couple of years ago, shot, body recovered. There are exotic cats out there. Whether there is an alien big cat on Cannock Chase, there is a black panther on Cannock Chase, the science doesn't support it. From somebody who's running a forensic science course, I'm telling my students that you can only go as far as the evidence that will allow you, and that is forensic analysis. These are tried and tested methods which we're looking at, which are used to provide evidence to convict people of crimes. The same techniques can be applied to finding whether big cats exist. Big cats exist in the zoos, so we know what their hair, blood, teeth, behaviour, size, calls are like. Mm-hmm. And if evidence is recovered from Cannock Chase which can be used to match with those creatures, and it does match with those creatures, then I, as a scientist, would say we have gathered the evidence that proves their existence. Mm-hmm. What I'm suggesting is that It's a matter of belief.
Matter of belief.
And until I see some scientific forensic evidence to support it, I will say there is no exotic alien big cat on Cannock Chase tonight.
A pretty condemning opinion. I think it's time we go and see what the local papers really think of the beast of Cannock Chase.